My name is Sister Alicia Torres. I am a member of the Franciscans of the Eucharist of Chicago. We're a religious community that serves on the west side of Chicago. When I was young, my mom actually got really sick. I remember as a little girl wanting to really help my mom and that our family could have like a normal life. Anytime I saw somebody that needed something, I wanted to go and help them. And it was almost like this was something that I did for God. When I was 13, one of the sisters took me down with a huge group to Boston and we prayed outside of this huge abortion clinic. We're praying the rosary, and so as only sisters could, sisters like, Alicia, do you want to lead a decade of the rosary? And so you don't say no to a nun. And I remember leading this decade of the rosary, and I'm just this little thing, you know, and these guys are just yelling at me and trying to intimidate me. And what I thought was, wow, what we're doing must really be important, because if a little person like me could be so much of a threat to those big guys, there's got to be something more here. When I went to attend university, I definitely was very interested and wanted to be an active Catholic. And when I got to campus, I made sure to meet the kid who was in charge of the pro-life group and get connected right away. My first year as a freshman, I went down to the March for Life with a bunch of friends, and that just continued. I ended up working for the Archdiocese of Chicago and coordinating even like an intercollegiate trip for college students from all over the city and the suburbs. When I was a junior in college, a group of friends and myself started to kind of try to take our prayer lives a little bit more seriously. And so at that time was when I really first felt this tug on my heart to be a sister. In the months and the years that followed, I met some sisters, I met some really great guys. I was like, I don't know if I want to be a sister. It's going back and forth, back and forth. I was kind of coming to my wit's end, and I went down to St. Stanislaus Kostka in the city, and they have perpetual adoration, this huge monstrance there. And I knelt down in the very front of the church so dramatically, and I was like, Lord, I know you've given me 100 signs, maybe 1,000 signs, but could I just get one more sign? And, you know, then we can just finish this off. And there was nothing, no feelings, no sign, no nothing. So I get back, and out of nowhere, I just look at my friend and I'm like, God wants me to be a sister. And from that point on, there was just this peace and joy that I didn't even know was possible. When I was a young sister, when I was a novice, I actually had a little accident. I hit my head and I got really sick. And I was in bed for basically 2 months straight. And it was really hard because up until that point in my life, I had just been go, 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 so fast, running marathons, running down to Springfield to fight legislation, all these sorts of things. Just, I mean, I'd wake up sometimes when I was working at 5 in the morning, the first thing I would do is start answering emails on my iPhone because you had to save people, you know, I'm like saving lives here. You know, so everything was so intense and so crammed together, and I don't think I ever gave myself the space to really breathe and to experience God's love for me. And what the Lord really taught me in that time of illness was, what I do is okay, but really what He cares about is me and who I am. I can do all sorts of wonderful things for the neighbors here, for wherever I'm called to serve, but all of that really means nothing if I don't have that relationship with the Lord and if I don't desire to share that with the people that I encounter. His desire for me and my relationship with Him is so much more important than anything that I do. And because of that relationship, what I do has meaning.